Why does gravity bend space-time? We've all seen the bowling ball on a trampoline analogy for gravity. Mass bends space-time, and that's why planets orbit stars. But have you ever stopped to ask, why? Why does something as seemingly empty as space and time respond to mass? Today we're going to be going beyond the analogy to uncover the true reason gravity shapes our universe. For centuries, gravity was the universe's simplest mystery. Isaac Newton said it was just a force pulling things together, like an invisible rope between Earth and the Moon. Case closed, right? Then Einstein showed up and said, guys, you've got it all backwards. Check this out. Einstein revealed that gravity isn't a force at all, it's something way weirder. When something as massive as Earth, that's 13 septillion pounds, or about the weight of 44 quintillion blue whales, sits in space, it doesn't just sit there. It literally wraps the fabric of reality around it. You've seen the bowling ball on a trampoline, but here's what they don't tell you. That analogy is missing the biggest piece of the puzzle. The real question isn't how mass bends space, it's why. Space-time isn't empty, it's not nothing, it's actually more like something. Think about it this way. If space-time were truly empty, like absolutely nothing, then mass would have nothing to bend. It would be like trying to make waves in nothing. Impossible, right? Well, instead, imagine space-time is an invisible ocean that fills everything, from here to the edge of the observable universe, 46.5 billion light years away. That's like traveling from Earth to the Moon and back about 570 quadrillion times. This ocean has properties. It has stiffness. It has resistance. It can ripple. We've literally detected these ripples as gravitational waves. And here's the kicker. Mass isn't just sitting in this ocean. Mass is energy. Frozen, concentrated energy. When Einstein wrote E equals mc squared, he wasn't just making a neat equation. He was revealing that a bowling ball, your coffee mug, even you, you're just incredibly dense packets of energy. And energy doesn't just exist in space-time. It interacts with it. It's like dropping a massive whirlpool into a cosmic ocean. But wait, it gets even stranger. Einstein's field equations, the mathematical heart of gravity, reveal something incredible. On one side of the equation, you have the shape of space-time. On the other side, energy and momentum. They are locked together, inseparable. It's not that mass causes space-time to curve, it's that mass energy and space-time curvature are two sides of the same cosmic coin. So the bowling ball on the trampoline isn't just about weight, it's about the energy stored within that bowling ball and how that energy interacts with the flexible fabric of the trampoline. Mass creates what physicists call stress energy in space-time. Our sun, which weighs as much as 333,000 Earths, creates so much stress energy that it warps space-time for billions of miles around it. Mercury, Venus, Earth, we're all just following the curves of this warped reality. Here's the thing that's really gonna mess with your head. You think Earth orbits the sun because of gravity's pull, right? Nope. Earth is actually traveling in a straight line. It's just that space-time itself is so curved around the sun that a straight path appears as an orbit, like an eclipse. The why is because mass is energy, and energy directly dictates the geometry of space-time. Energy curves space-time because that's literally what space-time is. A field, or better say, a geometric structure that responds to energy density. At the tiniest scales, we're talking a billionth of a billionth of a billionth of an inch. Space-time itself might be made of something. Loops, strings, discrete units of space and time itself. This is why black holes exist. Pack enough energy into a small enough space, like if you squeezed Earth down to the size of a marble, and space-time curves so extremely that not even light can escape. That's not magic. That's happening right now in countless places across the universe. In 2015, we detected gravitational waves from two black holes colliding 1.3 billion light years away. These weren't just measurements, they were proof that space-time itself can ripple, stretch, and squeeze like a cosmic jello. So here's the mind-blowing truth we've been building to. Gravity bends space-time because mass and energy are space-time shape. They're not separate things. Asking why does mass bend space-time is like asking why does water make things wet? It's what it fundamentally is. Right now, if you're watching this, you're not being pulled by Earth's gravity. In free fall, you follow space-time's curves. When you stand on the ground pushes you off that natural path. But we still don't know why space-time has these exact properties. Why does it curve in precisely this way? Why not differently? The answer might lie in something even more fundamental. The basic constants of nature itself. The strength of gravity, the speed of light, the way energy couples to space-time. These could be like the settings of our universe. Some physicists think these values might be the only ones that allow galaxies, stars, and life to exist. Change them even slightly, make gravity a bit stronger, or space-time a bit stiffer, and you've got a universe that collapses in seconds, or flies apart into cold emptiness. There is even a wild possibility that other universes exist with completely different space-time properties. Imagine a cosmos where mass repels instead of attracts, or where space-time has extra dimensions that make gravity work totally differently. We might just live in the one universe where the rules happen to be just right for us. These questions are pushing us towards something even bigger. Quantum gravity, string theory, loop quantum gravity. The next revolution in physics is coming, and it starts with questions just like these. So, the next time someone tells you gravity is just a force pulling things together, you can blow their mind. Tell them gravity isn't a force, it's the universe revealing that mass, energy, and the shape of reality are all the same thing, dancing together in ways we're only beginning to understand. From the apple falling from a tree to black holes swallowing entire stars, it's all the same phenomenon, energy shaping the very fabric of existence. Now here's my question for you. If gravity isn't really a force, what other forces in physics might be something completely different than what we think? Drop your wildest theories in the comments down below, I'd love to see them. And if you want to know more about the fabrics of space-time, do check out this video.